recently Chi Bailey, and welcome back to Let's Play Dragon Quest IV! I've healed up my party off screen, so now let's put out the evil flame of the Pharos Beacon! What is that chant? Ka 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 ka! What is that? I don't know. You got me on that one, boys. I think I'll win this flame war for boss time! Alright, our first battle, boss fight of Chapter 5. You want to use Sleep on the Tiger Ram, and then you want Maya to use Boom, or Bang. Boom is the next level. Fortunately, all of these guys are susceptible to Sleep, so we want to start crowd controlling them while we keep on working on the wonderful Wing Flamethrower that we're not going to put to sleep. Ow! This is why you want to take them out. Now, the Tigergram has a lot more HP than he did in the NES version. So he's going to take a little while. We'll take out the Flamethrower, let's sap the Tigergram, and throw everything else at the Flamethrower there. How Bang works against an enemy made of fire, I don't know. Got me on that one. But I'm thinking about switching to the Poison Moth Knife, but then I figured, let's just go with Bang and then go all out again. Okay, now I'm gonna switch to the Poison Moth Knife. Not much else we can do. Nuts. I should be okay on HP. When you're frozen in fear, you're basically paralyzed for one turn. You can't do anything. So, heal up just a little bit. Or maybe I should try putting him to sleep. Yeah, let's put him to sleep so he can't heal himself anymore. There we go. Or we could kill him before he can do anything useful, or before he can try to wake up from being that and try to do something useful. Now, mid-heal restores about, I think, like 80 HP or something like that. So it's pretty good. But I try to stick to the normal heal spell whenever I can to conserve MP. Alright, well, let's put the Holy Embers to use then. Will it work? Hey! Looks like it worked! It's the exact same flame as before, but it's a different color. I don't know how that works, but, well, there you go. Hooray! Let's get back to Porth Tunnel. Fortunately, whenever you're on the roof of a tower, you can use zoom without having to leave the tower, although you can just walk off the edge, too, but, well, there you go. Let's see, probably want to rest up because, well, for this next part, we might run into some pretty tough enemies. I mean, you never know. Plus, I don't want it to be nighttime by the time I get there, too. Where did Terneko say he was going anyway? Well, let's take a look around. Ah, there he is. Hey, how's it going? Well, we didn't put it out, we just replaced it, but what does that even mean? Happy as Larry? Well, I can guess what that means, but where did that expression come from? Is that an Irish expression? I don't know. I've never seen that before, but, no, you're useless. No, you got a family. Yes. You can put a wagon on a ship? Wow, that's a pretty big ship you got there. Okay, I guess we can take you along. And more party members! I'll be honest, I'm not too excited about Tarneka because he's not really good at all. One of the things in Chapter 5 that I'm probably not going to demonstrate is that he basically becomes a combination of a merchant and a goof-off. So whenever you execute a command with Tarneko in battle, he might randomly do something else, like a goof-off in Dragon Warrior 3. He's just so terrible. His equipment draw is worse than Ragnar's and his stats. It's like, why bother? So, and of the equipment that you can equip him with, it's not that cheap either. So, let's head on south to Mentos first. Pretend I don't have the world map code. So, yeah, I'm pretty much gonna neglect Torneco entirely for the remainder of the game. He'll still get some experience, but, well, you'll see. I'll go over there when we get to it. What's going on? Is that supposed to be, like, named after Hilton? Like the Hilton Hotels or something like that? I don't know. Maybe there's a pun that I'm not getting. Probably a lot in this game that I'm not. Well, that's very nice, but what does that have to do with us? No! I need you to replace Torneco! Okay, fine. But thou must! Well, at least we get to keep the wagon and the horse, so... Well, let's take a look around here. Sure, why not? Never heard of the guy before, but I'm sure he's great. Everyone seems to know about him, except everywhere that we've already been in the game. Oh, well, I don't really need that, but I'll keep that in mind, thanks. Let's see what they sell here. I'm not gonna buy anything, but, let's see. They got, like, the iron helmet, that's a better upgrade, or full plate armor, but I have something else that I want to do with my money, so save that for later, viewers. And, oh, right. One of the reasons why I kept the Cautery sword on Torneco was so that way he could give it to Solo there. And I'm pretty much going to sell all of Torneco's remaining equipment because I'm never going to touch him ever again for the remainder of the game. And what's in this well? Nothing. Wait a minute. It looks like there's something at the bottom of this well. Hey, a mini metal. All right. Well, I guess they actually put something in the well there for a change. I'm just going to loot the barrels in your backyard. Thanks. There's no window. They can't see me. How's it going, Big Hank? Oh, there you go. Yeah, I suppose so. Of course, you could help if you were a salesman like me, and you could just learn to stare into people's souls! That always worked for me. But, lightweight, huh? Sleeping in class. Well, I did that. Worked for me. Oh, yeah, I suppose so. He's not adventuring anymore. No, I'm just going to tell you the correct answer. I'm not going to get into a but-thou-must situation. Is he trying to speak with an accent? If he is, I don't know what it is. Sure, why not? I'm the silent protagonist! What can I say? I like how they sort of break the fourth wall there a little bit. Hey, all right. Well, we don't get a world map, but we get a treasure map. And it'll mark something on the world map eventually. Well, it will right now, but you gotta actually go out to the world map and check it out. So, I just lucked into it. I have a silent protagonist in this game. I thought there was something in there. Maybe I'm thinking of another house. Hey, alright, another mini metal. We should be up to, I think, 8? I think we're up to 8. I'd have to double check. Yeah, we're up to 8. Oh, everyone seems to be talking about this feverfew route. Oh, good for you, kids. Not that I need a scale shield, but I guess in case you didn't get something for Torneco, he's not completely useless. I still don't really care for him. He's more useful in the NES version, really. Because, well, you'll see, but you can get, like, certain weapons for him that not too many people can equip. And he's not bad on the physical attacks. But, well, you'll see. He's got decent HP, I just don't like him in this version of the game. He has another use, though. So, but not in battle. So, you can just feel free to sell his equipment. I wouldn't worry about it. I wouldn't even give him hand-me-downs. Just sell his stuff. How's it going? So that's where Parthenia is. Oh, maybe we ought to check it out. Maybe that's the one we're thinking of, Elena? Oh, well, yeah, it's tough business out there. Oh, hey, it's Borya! You guys just... Oh, I was gonna say, you're resting up here, but, yeah, they are, but, Kirill's not looking so good. Sure, why not? I'll do the best I can. Hey, all right! More party members! But since you don't have Elena or Kirill in your party, you don't get anything that's in their item bag added to your inventory. So not yet. You gotta get everyone from the chapter in order to get their stuff. And even if you gave the thief's key to Borya, he wouldn't have it. So no, you can't do that. One thing you can do, now that we have the ship, is we can go pretty much almost anywhere in the world. Ah, and here's chapter 3 of that book. So yeah, you can pretty much go anywhere you want, but I think top priority is recruiting as many party members as we can first, so that way they can get experience from all the exploration and everything like that, so I'll do the best I can there. Ah, remember that for later, viewers. Here's a seed of wisdom. I want to save that for later. Huh, why do they got a table on the rooftop like that? Seems like an odd place to put that, but... Well, okay, that's everything we can do here, but before heading to Parthenia, you know, there is one more thing I want to show you. I want to show you how to handle the boss fight that we just did in the NES version, because you can't enter commands directly, so... Rearrange my party as I have listed in the video description, and... Let's take a step back and take a look at the NES version, then. Okay, we're back in the NES version of the game now. Or, well, this is the first time I've shown it to you, but some of the names and of enemies and characters are a little different, but otherwise, mostly the same thing as before. But now we can't directly control our characters. The equipment is identical, some of the translation's different, but essentially the same idea there. And so since we can't directly input commands for our characters, as you can see, we don't have the follow orders tactic. So you have to choose one of the six ones for Nera and Mera there. And for this battle, I like using the offensive tactic there. Don't need to change my order around. Let's see how we're doing on HP and MP there. Yeah, I used a lot more MP in the NES version because the encounter rate is much higher in this version of the game. Huh, reminds me of all the bats in the, or not the bats, the gremlins in Dragon Warrior 2, but these guys, fortunately, are not nearly as hard as them. For boss time! And there is no boss music in the DS, or the NES version, so for this one, we want to go after the flamers. Now, on the offensive paradigm, hopefully Nera and Mera will do what I want them to do, and multi-targeting attacks take a while. Okay, Mera is still going to use Bang, because there's multiple groups of enemies, or they're all in separate groups, so she has to use Bang to hit them all. And then, hopefully Mera... Okay, she put the other one to sleep. So basically, when you're on the offensive tactic... Sorry if I say paradigm every now and then. But if you're on the offensive tactic, you'll use, well, offensive magic, or a physical attack if you don't have that, or maybe a debuff, or something like that. But first things first, we want to take out those flamers. The Bengal in the middle there has a lot less HP than in the DS version of the game. They really made the bosses a lot harder in the DS version, giving them more HP. Wow, we still haven't killed one of them? Well, at least we're not dead yet. Come on, Mera. Bang them to hell! Yeah, I think the flamers have a little bit more resistance to Bang than in the DS version. So yeah, some stats have been tweaked a little bit, but for the most part, what I do in the DS version would apply to the NES version, as long as you can get the tactics to do what you want them to do. So just a little example of how to use the tactics to your advantage, or at least as much as you can, during boss fights and random battles and such. So if you're stuck playing the NES version and you're not following along in the DS version, well, I just figured I'd just show this to you just to show how, you know, the tactics aren't nearly as bad as a lot of people, I think, say they are. Now, granted, there are instances where you're fighting a boss and you'd wish Christo wouldn't be casting beat or defeat on the boss over and over and over again. Okay, sometimes the AI can be a little stupid, but I'm surprised that it's as good as it is in the NES version, considering the limited memory they had. And this game was like 5 megabits back in the day. This was high-tech stuff back then, viewers. But alright, we got the flame going, and now we can head on over to Mintos. I think they call it the exact same name in this translation, but I've already been there in the DS version, so... But can we save Elena and get the Feverfew root? Find out next time on Let's Play Dragon Quest IV! This is H.C. Bailey, signing off. Have a good day!